So how do you get rid of the ums and ahs from your speech? This is something a lot of people really worry about. First of all, you got to realize everybody says ah and occasionally. It's no big deal. I can think of three people who say ah and all the time, more often than you do. David Letterman, Martha Stewart, Bill O'Reilly. What do they all have in common? They make tens of millions of dollars a year speaking. So maybe we shouldn't be so worried about the ums and ahs, and instead should focus on actually saying something interesting. Now, all things being equal, the fewer ums and ahs, the better. Because if every other word you're saying is people will start counting the ums and not focusing on what you're actually saying. Now, I have a technique I use with CEOs, presidents of countries, prime ministers, all over the world. It's amazingly effective. If you say too often or too often, simply type up the word small font, put a red circle around it, and a slash, the international no sign. No left-hand turn, no parking, all of a sudden, no no Here's what I do. I cut that out, and I tape that to the 12 on someone's watch, or just put it right on their cell phone. Whatever it is you look at numerous times a day. So here's what happens. After a day, you're going to be looking at your watch or your cell phone dozens of times a day. You do that every day. So after a day, when you say or you're all of a sudden aware of it. You have this sort of the Homer Simpson moment when you are aware of saying or or Now, after two or three days, your mouth and lips and tongue almost send out that or Your image comes up, but it still comes out. You still say the or But after a week, the image will come up. Now you can simply pause. Instead of the or coming out, you're pausing, you're aware of it. Now you'll come across more confident, more comfortable, more relaxed.